Good morning, everyone. My name is Irene Campbell, and I'm the family and community pastor here at Westwood Baptist Church. But more importantly, today I am Angela's sister in the Lord, and we were best friends for more than 20 years. So I am honored to be asked to lead today's service. Angela was a valued and much loved member of this church. We miss her. On behalf of the family, I give you a warm welcome to this service of thanksgiving. We know that not everyone who would like to have been here can be, but whether you're joining us here in person or whether you're on the live stream, I pray today you will know God's comfort and strength as we celebrate the life of Angela McRitchie. This will be a space to remember her, to reflect on her life and what she meant and means to us. It will also be a time for us to stand with our family, with Luke and Mary, Sandy, Tanya and Gary, and with our extended family and friends to love, support and comfort them at this sad time. The service will be one of thanksgiving and celebration of Angela's life, and it will be followed by a private family committal at South Lanarkshire Crematorium. You're going to hear different voices today, different people sharing in the service. The scriptures will be read by Jenny and Catherine. You'll hear tributes from Luke, Angela's son, from me on behalf of Kerith Counselling Service, and from me. All of us will show Angela's life through different lenses, and I hope that as you hear our stories, that they will resonate with you and that will stir up your own memories of Angela and share them with the family later. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Angela and all that she means to us. We thank you that she was precious to you, that she loved you, and that she is with you now out of her pain and suffering. We thank you that you understand our weeping and our sadness, but by your Son Jesus, you've come to bring joy to the world. So today, Lord, we ask for your presence. We rest in you, knowing that you are the God of all comfort and strength, that you are ever faithful, that you never leave us or forsake us, and that we can trust you to turn our weeping into tears of joy. We ask that today you surround us with your love as we remember Angela and as we honor her today. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The songs and Bible readings were chosen by Angela. The words were very dear to her, and she lived them out. Our first song is called 10,000 Reasons, that we bless the Lord in every season of our life and in every situation, in the highs and lows. So if you're able to stand, then please stand with us as we sing, "Bless the Lord, O my soul."
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. The sun. Song
reading is from John 14, verse 1 to 6. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I'm going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? And Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Anyone can be a mother. It takes someone special to be a mum. I know we have all seen different sides of my mum's life, but I've been lucky enough to be around her a lot, and therefore I have a bit more of a unique story to tell. First, I want to say thanks to everyone who's come here today to honour her memory and for all the kind words and messages both myself and the rest of the family have received over these last couple of weeks. Growing up, I was a bit difficult, but that's probably an understatement if you knew us. How do you manage with a son who didn't like his food touching? Just broccoli and chicken just needs to stay apart. Who struggled to make friends throughout school? Who lost his sister but didn't have the words or emotional understanding to fully comprehend what had happened? How do you manage when your world falls apart and collapses around you? I really don't know, but she managed while being the best mother she could, despite the pain she was in. I think we all resonate with that statement. She offered advice and support to whoever needed it, despite the difficulties she might have been facing at the time. She was selfless and oh how so independent. If Mama had a plan for how she wanted to do something, that would be how it would happen. It's no understatement to say she taught me how to be the man I am today. As I went through old documents and paperwork when we were tidying up her stuff, I found documents describing my initial autism diagnosis. It was a difficult read, but I now look on from that and see just how much of the basics that she taught me. I'm still learning. I just found out while planning all of this, I'm not supposed to just sit anywhere at a funeral. I was going to sit next to whoever brought the best snacks. I joke, but it's not a lie to say that I learned so much from my mum. I honestly don't think I'd manage to get a job and work full time if it wasn't for her impact on my life. Mum's impact stretched far beyond me and far beyond our family as well. She had a positive impact on everyone she met. No matter the situation, she had this ability to provide positive support. I think the amount of us that are here today just reinforces that. No one had a bad word to say about her. I had titled this section of my tribute, Farewell, but it's not a farewell. It's a transition. Mum has moved from her home in Westwood to her new home in each one of our hearts. And she will live on in our memories and our conversations that discuss her. As hard as it is for me to say this, she is at peace with Kira in heaven. Thank you again to everyone gathered here today to remember my mum. I want to also thank you for your prayers, both that have been said to us and ones done in quiet. Your prayers for our family bring much needed comfort at this difficult time. So if I could ask that you please continue to pray for our family as we continue to pray for you as well. And let me please close in a short prayer. Lord, we are thankful your daughter, Angela, is at peace with you in heaven. We thank you that she is reunited with Kira. We pray for guidance during this difficult time. I personally struggle to see a clear path forward without my mom in my life. We pray for unified support for each and every one of us while we struggle to process the loss that we've suffered. Mum's positive impact on everyone just makes the loss more widespread and more difficult. We pray that over the coming weeks and months, Mum's legacy and impact will become stronger and we will all fight a bit harder and love a bit stronger as a result of Mum's memory. Lord, in your name we pray for these things. Amen.
Our second reading today is from Romans chapter 8. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress, or persecution or famine, or nakedness or peril or sword? No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen. Thank you. These readings from the Bible were not just words to Angela. She believed them, and she had faith in the Lord Jesus. So in our service today, we can say with Angela and with certainty that nothing, not even death itself, can separate us from the love of God. And so it is with sure and certain hope that Angela is in heaven, now and for eternity. For as Revelation says, for God will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. For the old things have passed away. And the Lord says, I am making everything new. For Angela, that means there will be no more pain, or sleeplessness, or exhaustion, or grief. And that she is with the Lord. She's united, reunited with Kira, and she is in heaven with her Lord and Savior. Angela, we loved you. We love you. You will be missed, but you will never be forgotten. And you will live in the hearts and the lives of the people that you've left behind. Angela meant so much to us from different aspects of our life. But one of the longest times that she spent and most dedicated times were in Cerith Counselling Service. And May is going to come and give a tribute from Cerith.
Good morning. As Irene has introduced, I am May, and I'm the founder of Cerith Counselling Service in East Kilbride. I knew the McGritchie family quite some time before Angela came to work with us in Cerith. But today I want to concentrate on Angela and her unique contribution to the life of Cerith. Angela was very much a part of the organisation and served as a practice administrator for around 20 years. During that time, the organisation grew and changed, and Angela grew and changed along with it. An organisation like Cerith is built on commitment. That was Angela. A willingness to go the extra mile. That was Angela. An ability to work within a team and make everyone else on that team feel valued. That was Angela. An ability to listen understand and get along with everyone. That was Angela. Angela's organization skills were legendary, and she had an amazing gift for keeping all of the balls in the air all of the time. She cared very much for the clients and would frequently remind us if she thought someone had spent too long on the waiting list. And she didn't hold back, she was quite direct. We missed her terribly when she had to leave us due to a deterioration in her health a couple of years ago. And we, of course, kept in touch. Angela was always interested in what was going on in Kerith, so we kept her informed as best we could. Sometimes we talk about individuals who are the beating heart of an organization. Angela was certainly someone I would describe in that way. We miss her and will continue to miss her. Our comfort is that we know she was a woman of faith, and we believe that she's united with those she loves, especially little Kira. On behalf of Angela's friends and colleagues at Kerith, I want to say how blessed we have been to know Angela, to work alongside her, and to share with her precious years on life's journey. Our thoughts and prayers continue to be with Luke, Gary, Mary, Sandy, Tanya, Angela's friends, and the extended family. Thank you for everything, Angela.
Can we pray together, please? Lord, this is clearly a time of grief and pain and questions. Why so young? Why all the struggle that Angela had to go through? But thank you, Lord, that in the rawness of the pain, we can be reminded that when Jesus saw the pain of Mary and Martha in their grief, he wept with them. We have a God who knows and sits with us and cries with us in our grief. Thank you. And Lord, it's also a time for us all to reflect. Reflect on Angela's life with gratitude. All of us gathered here today were touched by Angela's presence in our lives, whether that be as a daughter, a sister, a mother, a friend. Our lives have been the better for knowing her, and for that we are grateful. Thank you for Angela's heart to give and to be concerned for others. That heart was evident in her concern for her family, for her church friends, and for her passion to serve in her work and her calling at Kerith Counseling Centre. Even when she was so debilitated in the last few years and unable to get out, we know that Angela kept so many of us in prayer. So yes, Lord, it is a time of grief and pain, but also a time of reflection and gratitude. And the thing that we can be grateful for, above all else, is that Angela lived and died believing and trusting in you. Lord, Angela was a daughter, a sister, a mother, a friend. But her most important position in life was that she was and is
a child of God. It's always hard to say goodbye to someone we love and treasure. But when that person lived and died in faith in you, then the blessing is that with the mourning comes hope. We can have a real living hope that this, Lord, is not goodbye, merely farewell for now. Jesus, you promise us in John chapter 11, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. And whoever lives believing in me will never die. Lord, we live in the hope of that promise of yours, meaning that Angela is alive with you, and one day all your children will be reunited again. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. When I became a pastor about 5 years ago, Angela said to me quite matter-of-factly, I want you to take my funeral. And of course I agreed, because that's what pastors do. But in my heart of hearts, I thought we would be 30 or 40 years down the road. And we'd both be in our 90s, in our dotage, and then by that time she might have forgotten. So I think I'm still in shock. We're all in shock that Angela has been taken to be with the Lord so young. But I am thankful to God that he took her gently to be with him, peacefully and painlessly in her sleep. Angela was born in Inverness, and she lived there until she was about 4. Mary's father died, and so Mary and the family moved into the family home in Golspie to look after her disabled cousin. Angela was a determined child. Determined, or bossy boots. Her brother Sandy got a hard time at times. Mary tells a story that one time she'd refused to give them a treat and said, no, no, you're not getting it. So Angela went into the room with Sandy, and Mary overheard her saying to Sandy, I'll slap you. And then you can cry. And then when Mum comes in, she'll say, oh, it's all right. And then she'll give you a treat and you can share it with me. And Mary heard it all, and that's exactly how it happened. She attended the local primary school and the high school in Golspie. She was in the music and drama clubs. She played badminton, and she was in the Scripture Union. And actually, when the teacher left who ran the Scripture Union Club, she and her friend led that group for a couple of years. As a teenager, she had many friends, and she used to go up to this local kind of youth hostel to hang out. They would go to the local farms, and, you know, they were out in the sticks, so they were out there. And one day, she came home with a huge box to Mary, which she said contained a hamster. But actually, it was a 5-week-old black and brown cat, which she called Split Pea, and it was with her for that time. She was a good student. Mary tells of she met some teachers who taught Angela just very recently. Angela worked hard, and the teachers remember that she asked for extra lessons to help her with her higher English so that she could get qualifications for nursing. Before she started nursing, she was an auxiliary in a hospital for the elderly. And she always took time to be with people, to stop and to speak to them. Nothing was too much trouble for her. She did her nursing training in Aberdeen, and that's where she met and married Mark. They were blessed with 2 children, for Kira and Luke. By this time, the family had moved into East Kilbride to Littleton. Angela and Mark came here to Westwood, and this was their church. and that is when we became friends. Angela also worked in Debenhams. Everybody thought she was so approachable and friendly. And that smile, as you can see. She had a real skill of making everyone feel important. She did experience loss and tragedy. When our beloved daughter Kira died from meningitis, Angela was devastated. But she faced this and the breakdown of our marriage with courage, with fervent prayer, and dependence on our Savior, Jesus Christ. She devoted herself to being a great mum, to Luke, and she championed Luke in everything. When you've known someone for so long, it's difficult to know what to leave out. So I'm simply going to tell you about my friend, Angela. She was the most self-effacing person I've ever known. I was always giving her into trouble for putting herself down. She lacked confidence in herself, but what she lacked in confidence, she made up for in love. She was incredibly determined. She followed something through if she had a plan in her mind. She loved colour and fashion. Everything had to match. Everything. She could see a colour once and be able to pick that up and then blend a scheme together to make everything just look wonderful. She loved bags and shoes. She loved designer labels like Radley and her beloved Marks and Spencers, where she would save up and then buy something really special. And her food was always M&S. Why? Because why wouldn't it be? It's always quality for Angela. She was so organized. She had an eye for detail and she planned everything in advance. She was always annoyed at me because I was a last minuter and she had everything planned weeks in advance. When we went on a holiday together, she would say about a month before, so have you got this organized? Have you got that organized? And I would be saying, I've still got a month to go. Don't worry about it. But she had it all done, including the bags packed, about a week to go. She had that certain way of everything had to be in its place and nothing out of place. She loved watching tennis. She was an avid darts fan. And we shared a love of detective dramas like NCIS and The Blacklist. We would phone each other and say, oh, did you get that last episode? She loved singing. She loved laughing. She loved chatting. She loved getting to know people and building relationships. If you were Angela's friend, you knew it. She always kept in touch. She remembered all the things that you were doing. She prayed for her friends every single day. She was a true and faithful friend. She loved her family. Her mum, Mary, was a great support, particularly in this last year where Mary was caring for her 24/7. She was so proud of Luke, and she loved Gary and welcomed him into her family. She loved Jesus, and even when she wasn't able to come out of the house and come to church, she was praying for us. And she loved me. And I'll be incredibly and eternally grateful to God for her love and friendship. I can't tell you how blessed I've been to know her and to be her friend. We're going to take time now to reflect on Angela's life. We're going to see some photographs and hear some music. Enjoy the memories. Quieten your thoughts. and reflect on Angela's life. And I hope that the photos remind you of the times that you have spent with her and spark memories of your own that you can share with the family after the service. The song is by Ed Sheeran, and it's called Supermarket Flowers. This is a tribute to Angela.
I took the supermarket flowers from the windowsill. I threw the day-old tea from the cup. Packed up the photo album Matthew had made. Memories of a life that's been loved. Took the Garrett Wilson cars and stuffed animals. Poured the old ginger beer down the sink. Dad always told me, don't you cry when you're down. But Mum, there's a tear every time that I blink. Oh, I'm in pieces, it's tearing me up. But I know a heart that's broke is a heart that's been loved. So I'll sing hallelujah. You are an angel in the shape of my mum. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go. And when God takes you back, he'll say, hallelujah, you're home. I fluffed the pillows, made the bed, stacked the chairs up. Folded your nightgowns neatly in a case. John said he'd drive, then put his hand on my cheek and wiped a tear from the side of my face. Now I hope that I see the world as you did, 'cause I know a life with love is a life that's been lived. So I'll sing hallelujah. Shape of my mom. When I fell down, you'd be there holding me up. Spread your wings as you go. And when God takes you back, he'll say hallelujah, you're home. To see the person I have become. Spread your wings, and I know that when God took you back, he said hallelujah, you're home.
Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you that you are a refuge, a place where we can run to for help. We pray that today you will remove any fears or worries or anxieties about the future. We trust in your goodness and love to sustain us. And we ask for your strength and power to hold Angela in our hearts and minds. And thank you for her influence and love in our lives, in the myriad of memories that we hold of her. Amen. We'll conclude this part of the service by singing In Christ Alone. Following this hymn, the family will leave to go to the crematorium for the committal. We would love for you to join us at the Torrance Hotel in the village for refreshments, to share your memories of Angela with the family. Please make your way there and the family will join you after the committal. There is also a box at the back of the church if you wish to give to Meningitis UK, a charity close to Angela's heart in memory of Kira and of Angela. And after the song, if you would remain standing for the blessing, let's sing In Christ Alone.
Alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. His cornerstone, his solid ground, firm to the fiercest trial and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease.
Almighty God, we rejoice in your promise of love, joy, and peace. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven. We pray these things through our Saviour Jesus, who died, rose again, and lives forevermore. Amen. Please be seated. In a minute, I will ask you to stand as the coffin leaves and as the family leave, and we'll exit through here. And then if you are going to the Torrens, if you would make your way there, and then we will meet you there following the committal. Please stand.